Hey YouTubers, how's everybody doing? Welcome to my kitchen. My name is JC and this is the Cuban Redneck DIY channel where we do cooking and grilling on Tuesdays, DIY stuff on Fridays. If you are a DIY subscriber and YouTube pushed you into my kitchen, do me a favor, click on the title where you will find multiple dedicated playlists to everything DIY. If this is your first time here, please do me a favor, feed the algorithms by sharing, liking, subscribing, or even commenting. I'm not really picky, any of the above will do. I just refuse to make cat videos, therefore I have to rely on your kindness to grow this channel. Today's video is one that is long overdue and it having to do with a very popular Mexican dessert called Tres Leches or Tres Leches Cake, and it's one that I've been putting off for a couple of months. Primarily because I am not much of a baker, and if you're going to make an authentic Mexican style Tres Leches or Tres Leches Cake, you need to bake a cake. More often than not, the cake that is associated for making a tres leche is called a vanilla chiffon cake. And although it's kind of easy, you don't have to worry about levitation and all of this kind of stuff. As I said, I am not much of a baker, and I think there's a lot of people in my shoes which love the dessert part of the, you know, the eating of the tres leche, but not really much into the baking part of it. I think that one of the easiest ways to get around that or cheat is to use a box cake. The problem is that there's 1,000 varieties out there, but after a lot of testing, I found one that I'm pretty pleased with. I've tried everything from yellow to regular traditional white. I even tried a carrot cake because I've had, one time I had a tres leche made with banana bread mix or whatever it was, and it was not too bad, to be honest with you. But I think the winner is this Betty Crocker super moist white cake, and I hope that this meets your criteria. So let's make ourselves a tres leches cake with a box cake. Check this out.
Before you get down on yourself over making a tres leches with cake mix, note that I will be publishing a recipe for an authentic Tres Leches Vanilla Chiffon Cake on the blog at CubanRedneck.com. This was given to me on a napkin a day or so after the video was recorded, and I do want to try it before I send you guys on a wild goose chase. Nevertheless, the person who gave it to me, who is Mexican, after trying my recipe said that it was legit, and I'm very proud of that. So as far as making this Tres Leches with cake mix, we are going to need the following. 1 box of Betty Crocker super moist white cake mix, 1 cup of water, 1/2 cup of vegetable oil, 3 eggs, 1 can of sweetened condensed milk, 1 can of evaporated milk, 24 ounces of heavy whipping cream, some sugar, as well as vanilla extract, a 9x13 baking dish, as well as a 9x12 baking dish. That may sound a little weird, but we'll get to that a little bit later. We're going to start by setting our oven to 350. And then grabbing a small baking dish, any size will do, to which we are going to add some water. We are looking to create a very moist environment for our cake. We are then going to separate the eggs. You all know that I like the in-between the fingers method, but please do whatever works for you. We're going to put the whites aside, and to the yolks, we're going to add 1/2 cup of vegetable oil and 1 cup of spring water. We're going to mix that until everything is incorporated and set it aside. To the egg whites, we're going to add 1/4 cup of sugar and whip it into a meringue. We are then going to turn our focus back into the cake mix, to which we're going to add 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract and fold the meringue into it. We can then spray our 9x13 baking dish, pour our cake mix, and put it to bake. In Florida, with an average humidity of 75, this cake would take 32 minutes on the dot. After the timer has expired, we're going to check the cake with a toothpick, and if everything is good, let it rest and cool off for an hour. An hour later, we can start to work on our tres leches sauce, as I call it. Deposit the condensed milk, the evaporated milk, the heavy cream, and 1 tablespoon of vanilla into a medium saucepan. Mix everything together and place on the stove under low heat for 5 to 6 minutes. Warming up the sauce will lower the viscosity of the mixture and it will soak the cake much better. While that happens, let's prepare the cake. If you have a 9x12 baking dish, flip the cake onto a cutting board and trim it so that it fits in a 9x12 baking dish. Otherwise, just string the top to make it flat, remove the crust from the edges, then with a skewer or a toothpick, punch little holes every half inch or so. Some people use a fork to do this, but I think it causes too much damage to the cake. Once the sauce has warmed up, pour it over, cover your cake with aluminum foil, and into the fridge it goes for at least 12 hours. The following morning, this is what it looks like. We can now prepare our topping. Add 1 cup of heavy whipping cream to a mixing bowl, 1/4 cup of sugar, and 1 tablespoon of vanilla. Whip it into a frosting, which we're gonna add to the top of our tres leches. I can already hear the ladies on the channel who's seeing me do this with a spatula say, "Hey jackass, there's a tool for that called a frosting knife." Yes, I know, but I'm not much of a baker and I don't have one. The whipping of the cream is going to raise the temperature of the frosting. It is ideal to put the tres leches back into the fridge for about an hour before serving. My friends, this is JC with the Cuban Redneck DIY channel. I thank you for watching and I look forward to seeing you next week. Please support this channel by subscribing, liking, and sharing. And don't forget to hit that notification bell. Thank you.